What is going on, guys? Wiser here, and I am here with Kadijk from OneHive and Victa, bringing you the episode 3 of our base building series. How's it going, Kad?
It's going pretty good, man. Thanks.
Awesome. It's good to have you here. Glad to get together once again. And our topic of discussion for today happens to be basically pathing. A big piece of what we're going to be talking about is mainly relating to hogs, but also a little bit on loons. We'll cover that stuff. There is a difference as well. We're going to touch on some spring trap discussion as well, I think, in this. So we got a good video here. So let's hop on over and check out the base that Kadijk has built for us. So what exactly was your idea here, Kad, when you built this? Show us what you're talking about when we're talking about good pathing.
About good pathing. Well, the pathing on this one is actually quite bad. I've built this one specifically to show the good examples and the bad examples, just like we did in the introduction video.
Yep.
And this one specifically built to show the basics again and go a bit deeper into the traps for mainly hogs.
Yep.
So first thing I wanted to talk about is the thing that most people screw up, and we talked about in the introductory video as well. Is the spring traps.
Yep.
And in this case, you see a lot of traps, a lot of spring traps, and almost all of them are quite badly placed. So let's start over here at the cannon at 2 o'clock. That spring trap, you don't see them often in high-level war clans, but it's a bad one because when you're coming in from the outside, of course, you're going to get a good trip on a couple of hogs. But when coming from the inside, it's completely wasted because your hogs aren't even going to path there.
I mean, even on the outside, unless they drop it right in the middle, if you dropped it from that angle, the hogs are going to not trigger that, right? Unless you have a whole bunch of them and they're kind of cluster on there. But even still, it's going to go to the corner and then go straight down to that side. So that's even kind of what makes this one not a great spring trap either.
No. And, well, yes. But the thing is, with hogs, they will wrap around defenses. I'll come back to that later.
Okay.
But that means that this one is actually quite effective, even when placed on the outside of a base. But I'll talk about that later.
Okay.
So first of all, another one like this on the left side at 9 o'clock at that wizard tower. That one is a one-way spring trap, as we would call it. When coming from the outside like this, hogs will path over it, but they will be beyond the spring trap before the spring trap actually triggers.
A big point about spring traps that I didn't know for the longest time that I wish someone had told me is that they don't trigger successfully unless the units are stopping on location.
So even wall breakers can walk over them without being knocked up because they will just walk over.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's a really important thing to notice. And originally, I had the one at 6 o'clock as well. I had an expo there, but just for the giant bomb in a few minutes, I moved it. Even that spring trap is bad, because you have to imagine that a wall is an empty space, pretty much. For hawks, it is. So nothing is going to stop over this spring trap, unless you're coming from the other direction. So avoid those traps pretty much at all costs, because they're not effective. They're not going to help you. They can easily be pathed around.
Mm-hmm.
So the last one I wanted to talk about is the spring trap in the middle. That one seems good at first sight. It's a good one. But even that one, it's iffy, because it will most of the time, I think this one will only trip one or two hogs. So even though it's in between the Archer Tower and the Tesla, I believe if you're coming from the 9 o'clock position, for example, you will be standing to the left side of the Tesla, move down towards the cannon, and then move towards the Archer Tower. And if they wrap around, only one or two will trigger the trap.
Yeah, or you'll just miss it completely. If you don't have a big group of hogs there, there's...
Yes.
Yeah.
So... try to avoid those. It's possible to have them, but Yeah, basically, it's the choice between losing one or two hogs or losing three hogs. I'd opt for the three hogs every single time.
Yeah, absolutely. This last spring trap is, like, in my opinion, your picture perfect spring trap.
Yes, it is. This is my favorite way to do it. Because between these two defenses, I would call them touching on this air between this spring trap. So, whatever angle you come from, they will pretty much be pathing on top of the spring trap. And that's also because hogs will wrap slightly around the defense. And this one will almost all of the time trigger two or three hogs, mainly three hogs.
Yep.
So I love those spring traps together with the one here at the
And
air defense.
both ways as well, because if anything's coming in the archer tower, it's going to do the exact same thing. Yeah, that's good
Exact
too.
same thing. And imagine the wizard tower being placed like this. You could place a second trap here. Be careful when placing too many spring traps in the same area. Like imagine four spring traps being here and the double set being here. Someone could enter in this area from 3 o'clock, disable this arch air defense, I mean, and eliminate four spring traps that basically, would wreck your whole base. So that's the next point. Try to spread out your spring traps. And with these offset queen chambers, you can even put a spring trap inside of the queen chamber, because most of the time they will be doing a king swap or a dragon swap, which will not get all of the defense in the archer queen chamber. Most of the time around this area, your troops will just peter out, unless you're having a really successful raid. So hogs will have to path through the archer queen chamber most of the time. So I prefer not to have a spring trap there, but it's still a valid place.
Sometimes you run out of places to put them.
Yes, you do.
Now, once you learn what a good spring trap is, it's hard to create those locations. But I've started as I've been building. I've literally been creating these corner to corner locations just so you can place those good spring traps. Another thing that I've been trying to do, that Wolf kind of taught me, was you can manipulate hog pathing slightly with neutral buildings as well. You can almost
Yes, you can.
force them on. So, like in this example, if you place like a builder's hut right there, you would ensure that anything would kind of stay in tight to that archer tower. It would go in between to get to that archer tower, right?
They will
So,
not path over build existing buildings, so you can use that to your advantage. Yes.
yeah, exactly. So I've been trying to force my spring trap pathing a little bit as well. So okay, great. So I think that covers springs.
It does most. There's one more last thing I wanted to mention,
for
and
it.
that's imagine this mortar being right here in the corner at 9 o'clock, and a spring trap over there. That spring trap would still be effective. I've seen it trigger three hogs even when surgically placing the hogs surgically there. But it's the same story as the spring in the middle. I prefer triggering three hogs and not just one or two. So even that one, even though it's properly placed, try to think of at which angle the hogs are going to come in. I think that's the most important thing with hogs. Always try to see at what angle they could be coming in, and try to find out every single angle in your base. I mean, hogs will always go to the closest defense. So,
Well,
try to look it up and see where they go and see if they will trigger the correct spring traps.
something as well, just while you bring that up, something as well that I didn't think of at when I was at least at first planning my gohos and stuff, when I first learned of three-star strats, I was always trying to envision my pathing. And there is a big difference in pathing with hogs and loons, because hogs stand on, on the outside edge of a defense, right?
Yep, they try to find all of the edges. Yes, exactly.
So, you're gonna constantly, if it's here, it's gonna stay on the edge, right? So whatever defense is sort of closer, it's gonna go that way, right? Now balloons target the very center, so you got to think balloon pathing slightly different, because a lot of times if there's I'm looking for an example in the base, which I don't really see, but loons are going to go from the center of every defense, and then they'll path to the closest defense from there, whereas hogs are going to more stand on the outside, and then from there, when the defense goes down, go to the next closest defense. It does make a difference. I think it's two tiles, or two, 1.5 tiles, I guess, technically.
Close to that, yes.
Yeah.
Maybe you could show it over here. Like, if this archer tower is over here, it's a bit close of an example. But loons, if they would be going in, standing on the center of this defense, and they might split up, as it is right now. Actually, that would be a better example.
Yeah, even if the mortar is up one.
If they're coming from this angle, even loons don't actually target the very center of a defense. It's really close to the center, actually.
Yeah.
And hogs will just, if they're standing here, they will actually be standing pretty much on top of this wall almost. Mm-hmm. They will always go to that wizard tower, even though loons will split.
Yep. Yeah. Good example. Okay.
I think that covers most of the spring traps.
For sure. Now, another little thing that we touched upon in the introductory video was the pathing to your double giant bombs, which yep. obviously is the most important defense versus hogs. If you don't have, if your bomb locations aren't set up properly, hogs are going to rip through your base. And if they are, the hogs are really going to struggle, or you're going to force them to do something kind of tricky to attack your base. Again, a whole part of base building, as you've mentioned before, Cad, is forcing your attacker to make decisions, right? That's really what it comes down to. And forcing your attacker to use as much time and troop space to achieve specific goals. So why don't you just quickly run us through the pure pathing for your double giant bombs?
Okay, so the most important thing when placing a double bomb set is making sure that it's far and away from the enemy, from your queen. In this case, the enemy queen could be standing in this nook here and shoot the air defense. So even this one is iffy. But just imagine this: the position overall of this giant bomb set is good, because it's pretty much on the other side of the base, and the attacker will have to go through, well, let's say, this whole section, and even these defenses, and maybe even the king before they get to your queen. So, yeah, that's basically forcing the enemy to make decisions when attacking your base. That's the basics.
Mm-hmm.
The second most important thing with your giant bomb set is make it triggerable in one way, which means funneling them in, as we talked about in the introductory video, but I'm going to repeat it quickly here. Make sure that when dropping a hog on the outside, like right now over this line, it would go to this air defense and trigger one or maybe even two of the bombs. And goodbye, double bomb set. So always try to place defense, for example, over here or over here, to lure them there, and then make them move exactly over the bomb set.
Yep.
The second most seen issue with double bomb set, or maybe even the most seen issue with a double bomb set, imagine this mortar not being here. And even with it there, I'd say it's iffy, because if they're standing on the edge here, they could do the same thing. That's called a triangle. Avoid these at all costs, because the hogs are just going to jump in to this defense, stand on the edge, and trigger this first bomb.
Yep.
And that leaves your, you can just heal it, and the hogs will just path through without a problem.
Like we had mentioned in the introductory video, it's so important that you really just over-exaggerate exactly what you're drawing here. There cannot be anything in there that is a defense. Otherwise, it's your double giant bomb has a good chance of not working properly, which means hogs are going to stomp you.
The only reason why you could do that is having a defense over here, for example, having one over here and one over here. I think two is a little too little, because it's quite easy to time from the outside to drop a single hog in to trigger one of them. Most people won't think about doing that, but I'd like to think in extreme cases, because highly skilled attackers will do this. I've seen it happen.
Yep.
So it's possible to make a path around like this, but it's really tricky to do. So if at all possible, prevent it.
Yep.
So the last way of single triggering a double bomb set would be, for example, with this Tesla. You'd say right now, if these defenses are gone, it's a good double bomb set. But actually, this Tesla messes it up. Because, as we mentioned before, Hawks will wrap around defenses. And because this is a 2x2 space, there's a, well, not a big chance, but there's quite a chance that they will actually trigger one of the two bombs. And making a heal possible there. So, even though they can be quite effective, it's kind of tricky. So having a building here, like a builder's hut, for example, would prevent this one from triggering singles, so to say.
Yep.
So it is possible to use a Tesla, but use it with caution.
That's a good statement. Because it's nice, especially for a first attack, right? You're scouting that base, not knowing where the traps are. Well, you're not going to think at first that the DGB is there until you actually know it's there.
Because the Tesla's there, yeah.
Yeah. So
that makes people really think twice, because all of these open spaces over here, for example, you could place a builder's hut here, for example, to close the gap pretty much on your defense-wise. Don't leave gaps in your bases. It's not a good thing. and place the double bomb set over here, for example, with a defense here. It will work, but once again, coming from this angle will trigger them one at a time, but it's possible. It can allow for really tricky ways to...
Yep. Yeah, you can set it up. You just, like you said, that's a good way to say it. Just use it with caution.
Yep.
Okay. Does that cover our DGB? Because you did have another base we wanted to go check out with four single bombs. I mean, we talked
about
that.
Yes, I think... it's good to switch now.
Okay, I'll switch this over. Hopefully this does this quickly. I hope that was it.
There we go.
Please don't be the same one. Nice. Okay, so...
It's a different one.
Yeah, it is. So you got four singles here. Similarities to the base, but what is your goal with when you're building a base with four singles?
Well, the idea behind having a base with four singles... This is a poor design, by the way, so... Don't use this.
Yeah.
your goal is to let your enemy attacker run out of heals.
Mm-hmm.
So what I've done here basically is I'm forcing a heal over this bomb. I'm forcing a heal over here, and lastly over here. That's already four heals gone. Well, with a kill squad, usually you can get one or two of those bombs. Example like we used before, entering at three, you can eliminate this air defense, eliminate over here, and eliminate the queen. So a quick gamble like this would be taken out by the kill squad. That would still leave you with two heals over these areas. Well, the thing is, what I've done in this base, that's one of the origins of having a Tesla hell. The south side over here actually forces another heal. And same goes for the compartment at 9 o'clock and even the one at 3 o'clock. All of those areas pretty much force a heal.
Yep.
A good attacker would be able to cover pretty much two of those compartments, like this. It's a bit off, but cover the giant bomb. And that would kill most of it, but that would leave them with no heal for this area, for example. So... My goal usually when building a four singles base is I try to make the enemy use at least four heals basically and one or two spells for the kill squad.
Yeah, you do not want to have two singles that you can heal with one heal spell.
Exactly.
Ever. Yeah.
Or having like a Tesla hell together with a single bomb.
Yes.
And yeah. Another way that I've actually used before is like having three wizard towers close together and maybe even a Tesla in there. That would force a heal as well, and it's basically a different way of having a Tesla zone.
Yep. Even a lot of point defense together, like if you had, you know, you got the three Teslas at six, if you had them up anywhere, you know, obviously we got the bomb spread out, but if you put a Tesla with a few point defenses and some hogs going, he's gonna want to heal that unless he's brought a couple giants to tank. But you know, there's ways to force heal locations, and your goal with four singles is to create as many of those as you possibly can.
Yep, here at the south is another example of that. The Expo, for example, is basically a high HP archer tower with a little more range. Hogs will take quite some time to get through an Expo. So you could actually use that to your advantage. And these three Teslas in this case is actually a good example of it. They will be beating on their hogs. So even this small area of 3 to 4 defenses there would enforce a heal, basically.
Yep.
So you can even use your Expos to stall hogs, specifically to stall them, so they would still need a heal.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, normally, would you have an Expo on the outside like that?
No, definitely not.
Okay, I didn't think
so. The idea that Iron Wolf told me is an Expo, as I just said, is basically an archer tower, damage-wise, but the range is a bit longer and it's quite tanky. So, basically, where would you put your longest range, your best defense, like with the longest range? Where it would be most effective is basically in the middle of the base, because it would cover most of the base.
Yeah.
So it's possible, like a lot of people, as we talked about in the first video, put one in the Archer Queen chamber to protect her, basically. Yep. So think about where you put them. Just don't put them in random places like I did here in the south.
Yeah, you don't want them. You want them protected. You want them buried. One thing we were talking about too is I like using them to force, like if I have a double giant bomb, kind of like you did here, not set up at 6, but if you still had the DGB there, well, you're forcing a heal here no matter what, and then the hogs are going to go in and die anyways, even, you know what I mean? So it's a double win for you because you're forcing him to use a heal, and his hogs are still going to die once they beat through all this stuff, right? Yeah. So I use, you know, Expos a lot, and sometimes air defense. Obviously depends on how you build the base, but somewhere in my double giant bomb pathing, because maybe not air defense specifically, air defense just have high hit points, but Expos specifically usually force a heal. So if I can force a heal and then he loses all his hogs to bacon, then it's a huge success.
Yeah, that's one thing I forgot to mention about the double bomb set. Try to make them use a heal to get to the double bomb set when using suicide hogs. So in this case, from both sides, you would have to invest more than like 6 to 8 hogs and a heal to get to it.
Yep.
So for me, the minimum to trigger with suicide hogs is basically 6 hogs and a heal, which for an attacker actually is a win. So try to keep that as a bare minimum.
Yeah, give up the least for the most.
Precisely.
Pretty big theme in base building.
It is.
Yeah.
And the last thing about hogs is the skelly traps. I like to use them like this. I think they're a bit badly placed in this example, but the one here at 9 o'clock is actually a good one. They can be beating on hogs for a long time. And for an attacker that's running out of heals, especially in a singles base, the skellies can do a lot of work.
Yep.
So what I try to do when building a base with 4 singles or even a double bomb set, I try to imagine where my attacker would come from. And in this case, usually it would be the 3 o'clock position, but you need to get the queen either way. I try to place my skelly traps where the attacker would enter with hogs specifically. So in this case, think about entering at 3 o'clock. That would be taking this out, as we said before.
Yep.
And in that case, I would want to have a skelly trap over here and the one at 9 o'clock.
Yeah, the longer the skellies are beating on the hogs, the more likely it is you're gonna force an early heal. You're gonna make him worry when he's got a trail of skeletons running through, and he's gonna be tempted to heal early, and that could really throw the attack off. So
yes, it can. And the second reason why skellies are placed like this, I personally like to split them up, because if there's not a poison used for the CC troops, they will be split and can't just easily be poisoned. So if an attacker sees skelly traps pop, they will usually in the heat of the moment, they might just drop the poison here.
Yeah.
But then over here in the south side, the second skelly triggers, and still those skellies will be chasing the hogs. It's not a lot of damage, but every bit counts in the end.
It does. It absolutely does. I can think about it in a singles base. If you have the skeletons running through with the hogs almost the entire raid, and the hogs hit one of those singles near the end of the raid, that could turn the tide. I mean, like you said, every little bit counts.
Every little bit counts, especially when the attackers run out of heals and the skellies are beating on them while giant bomb triggers.
Mm-hmm.
I can tell you now, rip those hogs.
Real quickly, what would your opinion on using air skellies be?
They can be good in specific cases. The reason why, personally, I almost always put them to ground is because, pretty much every single attack has a ground portion. So a Laloon attack, imagine coming cold-blooded in here, will come through ground and trigger this skeleton trap, which will stall, even though it's just a tiny bit, it will stall them. Basically that. And air skellies can be good, but think about it carefully, because usually they have more value on ground because they can stall ground troops regardless of the attack.
Yeah, and you know, goes back to the basics. When we talked about in that intro video, you still need to protect against P.E.K.K.A.s and witches and things like. So skeletons are amazing defense against P.E.K.K.A.s specifically, right? Because it makes them stand there for an extra 10 seconds, taking the slow swipe at every single skeleton while they just get beat on. So.
And even a king or a queen, like a queen is such an overkill for just one skelly.
Yep, that's right.
So yeah, they're amazing against that.
Whenever I do my farming, I absolutely hate when I hit my ability and a skeleton trap pops at the same time, because mm-hmm. then you use your ability on the stupid skeleton. So yeah, there's a lot of tricky ways.
That's a waste of like 2,000 damage. Almost.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay. So I think we pretty much covered the ideas here. Obviously, when you're thinking about pathing, remember hogs stay to the outside of defenses, where loons go more towards the center of the defense. Remember, make sure your double giant bomb pathing is pure. Otherwise, it's going to be a waste. You'd be better off building a four singles base. And if you're building a four singles base, it's the idea behind it is creating as many heal zones, kill zones, whatever you want to call it, as possible. So your attacker just runs out of heals in the end. So, you have anything else really to add at this point, Kat?
The last thing I'd say is what I do. Imagine coming from every single angle to the base with mm-hmm. hogs. Just imagine every single angle and see how they would path and see what comes out of the raid. If you can cover your base with heals, pretty much.
Yeah, that's great. You know, just really just stare at it and imagine every single point on all your outer defenses. Well, where would the hogs go from those outer defenses? And you get a really good idea of if your pathing is good or your pathing sucks, because all of a sudden you're like, oh wait, that goes right to my air defense. Well, I probably don't want that. So you throw in another defense on that side or something like that, right? You sit there and at the end, and I don't know about you, but I sit there and just stare and constantly just move one building around at a time once it's complete.
Yeah, I tend to stare at it. Like, yeah. I place my air defenses, my Archer Queen chamber, and I just stare at it just to see where everything has to go before it's a good base. Yeah. It takes time.
Okay, well, you want to wrap this one up then?
Yep, it's good.
Okay, beautiful. That does it for your Wisdom from Wiser, guys. Just trying to help you bag that next 3-star, and until then, I'm out.